finish recording. Welcome to a brand new decade and a brand new episode of The 6-Inch Show, episode 51. I'm Fly Guy from flyguy.net, and this is Matt from many cool Instagram channels. Instagram.com/StarWarsTheBlackSeries/ToyTribes/6-Inch Legends, and a whole lot more. Can you believe it's another decade? I actually forgot it's another decade. I was kind of like, what?
Look, I don't know. I kind of feel that 2020, the future is now.
I know. Where's my flying car, man? I mean, what?
Yeah, look, it was, you go back, I don't know. You go back 2007, 2008, and there was all these things like 2020 symposiums about what will happen, how we're going to plan for the future. And it feels like it's exactly the same.
Wasn't Blade Runner 2019 or something? It was supposed to be something like that. Anyway, little point there. I don't know if you do hear this week, Sid Mead died.
I saw your post.
Yeah, he was an inspiration behind a lot of early Star Wars stuff and kind of inspired Ralph McQuarrie. And if anybody doesn't know, it's a fascinating insight into the guy who really some incredible designs for some of the films and us toys that we're talking about and comics as well. So anyway, episode 51. Last episode, we did a best of our top 10, Matt and I, from all of our favourite Black Series and Marvel Legends figures. This show, just literally recorded on the 3rd of January, is going to look back at the best photographs of our best toy photography, we think, from all of 2019. So Matt's done a good job of curating some together, and I've had a quick look at some of them, and they're pretty amazing. So sit back and relax and look at some of the best. I think it's fair to see the best toy photographers of 2019. I mean, you're already cherry picking out some of the best. And we've put these in kind of some order of some of our best engagements, some of the most viewed that you've just had on your channel. And we'll mention as many as we can tonight, show permitting. So first off, some Star Wars stuff on toy photography, then some Marvel Legends. But before we do, very quickly, episode 50 and your comments and what you thought. So let's have a quick look at that, good or bad. Let's have a look and see what you guys said. So what did we have here? So again, this was the top 10 from Matt and I. Christopher Miller saying the Razor Crest, the first Baff of the Black Series line is a knob. Next figure will come with a steering control yoke. I like it. Yes. Craven Blackness show gents, he's listed at some of his top 10. So everybody had pretty much a lot of the stuff you and I had. Mud Trooper Han, Skiff Lando, Cameron Guard, was that in 2019? I think it was.
It could be when they bought their figures. True. Skiff Lando and Gamorrean Guard was 2018.
Yeah. A lot of people love that heavy infantry Mandalorian, and the pops that I just saw in the last couple of days look stunning as well. So he's definitely a heavy one that appears quite a lot. A lot of people just rounding out, seeing that all the figures look good. Everyone else's top 10s, again, looking pretty solid. Mandalorian is just such a heavy influence on a lot of people's toys. Hugely done. The Han Solo Mud Trooper appeared quite a lot. Palpatine, Cara Dune, and Kenneth Curley Jr., thank you as always. Darth Emmett wants that Nightcrawler. Why did you not get it, Darth Emmett? What are you doing? Anyway, on with the top toy photography of last year. And we're going to start off looking at Reach. And I think we're going to start with, we're going to start at Papa's down at the bottom, or are we starting with Mr. Stormtrooper Davis? I can't remember.
Mr. Stormtrooper Davis.
Okay, here we go. So, in no particular order, this section, right?
No particular. The Reach and Impressions really is just about, we've got a 15-to-1 of what was the most liked pictures. Mm-hmm. The Reach is kind of, the Reach and Impressions is just looking at which pictures kind of got out there organically and got out to a lot of accounts without necessarily the number of likes that the other shots got. But we're all talking about if these kind of images here are kind of representing shots or numbers 16 through to kind of 25.
Gotcha. This is pretty stunning. There's a lot of toys in there. There's a Hover Tank Commander, there's 3 Stormtroopers. In fact, there's more than that. 1, 2, 3, 4 Sand Troopers in there. A lot of effort went into that shot, and that was by Mr. Stormtrooper Davis. I like that. That's quite nice.
Yeah, it's kind of got that World War II kind of thing going on when you'd see the new platoons going out.
Yeah, I was just going to say that. It's like half of that picture, there's nice symmetry going on. They're very kind of nice split between the completely muddy and done-in troopers to the nice new ones coming off the boat. I like that. And the nice little touch of the hover tank pilot, I guess, maybe bringing them in.
Do you reckon we're going to get a... this kind of leads me to think, do you reckon we're going to get the vintage collection, or we'll get the Mandalorian kind of dirtier stormtrooper like we did with
the Red One? I think they call it Remnant, the Remains, yeah. Or they call it Remnant Stormtroopers. So yeah, I don't see why not. It's slightly different helmet, I think, but pretty much the same. I mean, you're given another excuse basically to Hasbro there to just bring it another product, so they really should listen and take advice. But that's nice. It's a very nice pick. I must make sure to like them all as I go along. This is another one by Green is Yellow, and it's a really nice composed shot with one of our favourite figures we both loved for 2019. And that was by, again, Green is Yellow. Nice composition in the background.
Yeah, and I was just going to say that, you know, so many of these pictures revolve around, and I guess that's what generates the likes and the interest, General Kenobi, Mandalorian, heavy infantry, like all the popular figures when done with great photography then generate more interest and engagement and all that kind of stuff. So it might get a bit repetitive, but we'll wait and see.
Okay. All good. Who else have we got here? We've got, this is a collaboration by Venomous, who did their kind of a little... gorgeous piece of art for the show, which we'll have as the thumbnail on this one going forward. And Captain Ordo doing this. That's pretty awesome.
So you can click through awesome. For the original images.
Oh, wow. God damn.
And one more.
Did I miss one?
Yeah.
So I did. Holy balls. Okay. So from toy to gorgeous illustration.
Yeah.
That's pretty impressive. His work is stunning, though. Venomous has been around for a long, long time on Instagram. And even then, I think before that, was on Tumblr or Twitter. But yeah, he's done some stunning. Oh, my goodness. And we should talk about that. Oh, my God. The ending of that show. How good was that? To me, that was just the highlight of that episode, the little baby Yoda on the speeder bike. But. Yes.
I dug it. I thought it was a great episode. It was kind of funny how it started, and I was thinking, please don't go down this path. Even though I really loved that first 5 minutes, it did feel like it went that little beat too long, but it was hilarious. It was funny, but it was like, oh, please don't make this Thor Ragnarok the whole way through kind of thing. But he had his 5 minutes to do his Taika thing, and he still had other Taika moments in there, but it went back to the kind of tempo of the series with a few Taika touches, but that opening thing and the kind of social trouble Jason Sudeikis got into for punching Baby Yoda.
Yes, I know. That was a good show, though. I was really... gives me a bit of faith in Star Wars. Nothing's perfect, but it still was such an enjoyable piece of TV. Let's move along. And the next one we have is coming up by... non_1072. That is a nice show. I think we showed that on one episode. I can't remember, but
we did. Definitely did. You've already got the love heart to it, so
oh, there you go. So I did. I loved it before. I love it again. It's such a well composed show.
As is all of Stu's work. I shared a post recently, and again, the thing that Stu's strength is, and probably above most, is posing. And if you look through all his pictures, they're always incredibly posed. Mm. It's not just the posing of the front two in focus. It's the posing of the guy who you can only see his leg kind of thing. Like everything, everything's perfect. There's a rocket trooper in there, like I can see right now. And it doesn't matter that you can't see his face. It's all there. There's always depth. Everybody's doing something and everybody's the focus, even if they're not actually the focus of the picture.
Exactly.
And that's... you know, it's kind of Stu's page where if people ask me, oh, how do I get better photos? You can get better photos from, I guess, better cameras, better lighting, all this other stuff. But at the end of the day, if you learn how to pose properly, and I don't know how to pose figures properly, But if you learn how to do it from Stu's page, for example, it would do half the work for you.
Yeah. Yeah, we've seen some of his work through the entire 50 episodes. And I know that for sure. We've seen a lot of stuff. There you go. There's an almost classic scene from The Mandalorian, even though it was 22 weeks ago. But it could be literally the one we've just seen the other night. But yeah, he definitely has some good work. But you're right, posing is hard. It's there was a nice little show on Sideshow a while back, which was kind of interesting, how to be a poser. And they had one of their kind of artists there talk about some of the ways that you can pose. It was very interesting. It wasn't always helpful, but it was certainly kind of interesting to see some techniques, just as you said, that you can apply. And non_1072 Stu, as you call him, he's from Scotland. Yay. Anyway, moving on, we had impressions and engagement next was the kind of list we had. And let's start off with, oh my God, this is a cracker. I don't recall actually seeing this one before. Let me just bring that up on screen. Wow. Did we share that before? I don't know, but it's like stunning.
That's so I don't know. How many weeks ago was it? 9 weeks ago. We must have.
That's pretty cool. Little mini Ray from the kind of toy box. Galaxy of Adventures, I think.
It's either toy box. Or Disney Infinity without the weapons. I can't tell.
Nicely done.
I don't want to get my glasses out, but I'm going to say it's the Disney Infinity.
Figure Hertz is behind that one. Very cool. Nice and original. I haven't seen anything like that before, actually. Next one is here. Oh, wow. Good God, that's a piece of art. Look at that. I bet that took ages to get right. Just ages to get the lighting. Just probably took 100 pictures to get that one there. But that looks awesome. So we've got a Gree with a different helmet, a Rex, and a Foxy. And just some great looking explosions in the background and great posing, as you mentioned.
Yeah.
Wow. That's pretty stunning. And that comes from Everything Kylo. Very, very nice. God, even that one there just looks like, it just looks like real. Such a good figure. Such a good figure. What have we got next? It is South P24, who we've featured on the show before. So we've still got to get to our top photographs of 2019. These are just some other ones that we highlighted, or Matt's highlighted it. And that's a nice Rise of Skywalker show, I guess.
And a nice custom painted head. And I know everyone's going to say they don't want it, but I want my photo reel Kylo Ren, maybe two heads for obvious reasons. I'd like to see the Ben Solo / Kylo Ren kind of figure to finish off, I guess, this latest trilogy. And again, lots of Kylo Rens we've had, but this film offers one more opportunity for a slightly different figure and giving us one last hit at a Hasbro Adam Driver head.
That's a good point. We could do with another shot. That is a different shot he's got there before. But I like the Palpatine with the white eyes, which is a nice little touch there. So that's just some of the ones that had the most impressions, the most engagement. But now
there's one more.
There's one more. Yes, this is why we have you here. Papa Palpatine, my apologies. Let me, how can I miss that one? Good God. Let me just bring that up here. I'm getting excited by the top 15. I'm just not paying attention. That's very nice. And this is by The Mandalorian. Okay.
No, the Papa Palpatine.
Papa Palpatine photography. Okay, gotcha. Just rereading it there. That's nice. Which maybe in the future.
Could be season two.
Yeah, you just don't know, do you? Those spars, who was that? Who could that be? Nice shot.
I thought it might have been Gideon, but obviously it wasn't. So it kind of points in his direction. I guess we'll wait and see. And it makes sense to at least put one or two little Easter eggs into season one for season two. They always did it in Clone Wars. They did it in Rebels. They've done it in everything Filoni's been a part of. So
Did you think it was Gideon?
No, it was just, I thought it was Boba Fett, but it could have been Gideon, and it obviously wasn't Gideon by the time we got to the end of the season, that it wasn't him. But so yeah, let's wait for season two and whether they bring him back or not.
Let's see what happens. Okay, so we're now down to Ken and Dan for 15 to number one, the top toy photography of 2019, Star Wars Black Series from Matt's page, instagram.com/ Star Wars The Black Series. And you will see some ones that we've seen before this year, but boy oh boy, some of these are really good. So let me just...
I should add that, you know, this is now based on purely likes and different things to consider in this and take into it all. And that is, I guess, the last couple of months has been incredibly strong for the page, with the Mandalorian gearing up and the Mandalorian figures being released and General Kenobi being a very popular figure and photographing well and getting lots of interest, and then also Rise of Skywalker happening. My page has added, I think, 6,000 followers in the last month and 6 weeks, 6,000 followers in 6 weeks. So the algorithms are going a little bit crazy, which also feeds everything. So all 15 pictures are great. The ones that are at the top are stellar pictures, but we're talking about there is a high concentration of images from the second half of the year or in the last 3 months versus earlier in the year. And we'll talk about that when we get to the end of the 15. But, you know, this is a representation, purely stats, purely analytics from Instagram, telling us what was the most liked pictures on the page for the last 12 months.
I think whatever you're saying as well is you love all your children equally. There's no one that you're trying to... Okay, yeah, I get it. It's the algorithms. Let's share that off. So number 15, in terms of all those rankings and things that we've just mentioned there, is by Jazz Ink Dioramas, which I guess is a...
Go ahead. Jazz Ink is the...
Waffles?
Waffles is the photographer, and Jazz Ink is the diorama maker that made that Tantive for hallway.
Nice shot. I love the stormtrooper in the background, actually. He's pretty cool.
So you can click on for the art that it's based on as well, because it was based on some Lucasfilm commissioned art, if you hit the arrow.
Oh, right. Maybe from Battlefront or something, or I don't know.
I think it was actually just a commissioned piece, like one of those fan art galaxy cards or Topps cards, but you know, Lucasfilm goes out and gets artists to do stuff.
Wow, that's pretty damn cool. I love the artwork and the figures. Nice. Okay, that's number 15. That's pretty good. Nice job, Warfels.
And I can add with the thing, just for those who are keeping tally, because we can't see it anymore, we can't in Australia anyway, that was 5,080 likes for that shot.
Nice. This is by Captain Ordo, who we just mentioned earlier on, but nice bit of space walls in the background, and lots of troopers, and Darth, a very strong figure still, a very good looking figure. And there we go, I love these, how they do them, the shots behind, that's nice. Mary Sithmuth. That is super.
Sean's thing came with 5,114 likes so far.
Just got another one.
There we go.
That's awesome. That is. I love that the space wall is such a good product. I'm finally making room where I can display some more, but they're a great, great product. Definitely cool. Love that. A nice little touch is the glass floor.
Yeah.
The sheet of glass can actually do quite a bit of the reflection instead of a highly polished surface. That's a nice little touch for toy photography, actually, is that the reflection in the glass can really work. So like a tabletop or something. Nice. I like that. I just learned something. Number 13 coming in on the list of our top 15 Star Wars Black Series photography for the year. Now, that's awesome. That is awesome. Trooperi, always one that we share. That's damn cool.
Now, I think this launched.
What's that?
This launched just as the first trailer released, or clip released, whatever it was, the first the first look that was publicly released, and that kind of image was everywhere, and definitely one that was begging to be done and has been done and was proved incredibly popular.
He's done a great job.
170 something.
Yeah, and he's clearly just glued these, or he put some blue tack or something on the back of. He's not pierced them through it, but it still looks the part. It looks good. But that's nice. Nice job. It was such an iconic scene from the trailer for The Mandalorian, which really says a lot, that's for sure. Nice job, Trippetti. I'm sure we'll see him again somewhere in the lists. Number 12 in the top 15 is... Wow. Okay, that's awesome. Josh DeLef with the custom. In fact, a friend of mine was sharing this with me today, asking, is this a real product? Can I buy this product? And I was like, yeah, it's just been customized. So some Beskar tweaks there, I think, on the armor. But
So the custom's from JP Valander.
Yep.
Obviously, it's a Mythic Legions troll in the background.
Is that what it is? Okay.
Yeah.
Looks awesome. Looks really good.
Yeah, look, and to be honest, this was shot in 2019. I only shared it today, and it's technically 5,484 and counting, because I shared it a couple of hours ago. What is it, 13 hours ago? And it's just churning away. I'm sure it will end its run higher up than 13. But as we don't know where, that's where it currently is now. So
that's a stunning pack. Again, it's just the out of focus and the focus, and it just works really, really well. And a nice bit of, pardon me, customization on the Mando front. Number 11 in the Toy Photography Black Series rundown is fan popular Darth Revan by Augie's Toys. Very nice. Nice and kind of simple, but just with some effects. Go on.
Recreation of that classic Revan poster or Knights of the Old Republic art or whatever it was. And look, it gets its run every once in a while, this image, and this one's done really well and hit at a time where everybody was obviously, I think I shared it. I can't know if I said it there. No, but I think it came at a time where it was like Revan had been missing from the page for a while. Mm-hmm. And it was kind of like, I hadn't seen Revan pictures, and then all of a sudden Revan stuff started showing up, and it's obviously a fan favorite. We'll see how the new Revan goes from gaming classics or whatever it is, the Jedi Revan.
Exactly. We're into the top 10, number 10 of the best toy photography of 2019. And that's a belter. That's really nice. So we've got Anakin in kind of almost like an Obi-Wan's outfit as well there. Yoda looking good. A custom mace. Classic old Obi already. A couple of Imperials. Whoa, of course, Clone Wars, yes. Rebel Jawa. We've got the Clone Wars TV show coming in March. So there may be scenes like this in it. We don't know, I guess.
Yeah, what is it? Is it 12 episodes?
I can't remember. Well, I just know it's the lost episodes. Nice shot, though. Again, Space Walls. You must buy Space Walls. They're so cool. Hey, very nicely done. Okay, number 9. Who have we got? Shooting the Galaxy. I can see the name there. That's one that's always been on this show a lot. Definitely recommended. Oh, wow. That's badass. Perfect symmetry. That's something I always love in good photography, is that balance and the symmetry. It really works well. Two punch troopers.
To purge with a couple of, the variation was obviously the black and the red pauldron. If I remember correctly, the black one is photoshopped.
Yep.
But, you know, I remember when we shared this, and when I shared it, the number of people questioning whether it was a toy picture or a digital picture and all that kind of stuff. But, man, it just looks like it's out of the game. And it looks like that picture that we're all sharing when they announced the Purge Troop was coming. We're all on Google finding what images do we have of fallen Jedi Purge Troopers, and it's like this one.
I agree. That is superb. And again, Space Walls. It's like the product to buy if you're into toy photography. Beautiful.
That one cracked 6,000 likes.
Wow. That's a lot. Let's get rid of some of these, and then we'll move on. So we're down to number 8 in the top toy photography for Black Series. Good God, that's stunning. That's really, really cool. My God, I love the kind of picture quality, that the kind of differences in contrast and the like glow of the light and the dewback nativity scene. I like it. Probably more realistic than the other one.
Look, don't say that. I already got, I can't tell you how many comments I got in private messages about this is disrespectful and blah, 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 blah. And nothing we do is for offense, and everything is, I don't know what you call it, artists.
Well, freedom. Both are fairy tales. There you go. I've said it. So, but that's awesome. That is a very nice shot. I love the dewback just sneaking out the side. And IG-11's down at the bottom completely.
Wow. And are the Jawas three wise men? I don't know.
Who?
The Jawas. Are they three wise kings?
Oh, so they are. Okay. Gold, frankincense, and bounty hunter droids. Okay. That's fab. That's a really good shot. I'm just making sure. No, should we def up? Yeah, I do. I started realizing the other day that I didn't follow a lot of people. I'm so lazy. Sorry, a few people were giving me a row saying, why don't you follow me? I was like, I just haven't really taken the time. Another cracker of a shot. This is number 7 here. Wow, that looks so good. Tiny iPic photos, doing a kind of recreation of, well, kind of the opening sequence at the bar, but not.
And this was before? Was it before it came out?
October 17th. That would have been, no, it would have been out just then.
Yeah, we got it. I can't remember.
Oh, was it? I can't remember. No, it was November, wasn't it? It was November the 6th.
November, yeah. So it was before it came out.
There you go. Nice shot. Really cool. I like that. And the tone and the colors again. Wow. That's nice. Nice shot. Tiny eye picks. Let's move on to number 6 in the toy photography of 2019. And this one, God, the Mandalorian, as you said, is the latter half of the year. So another pretty stunning, stunning shot and custom from Stronix 117. Wow. This is the one that Hasbro's probably going to be bringing out any day. So updated Beskar armor, probably a jetpack, probably a decent cape. What a difference that paint makes to that figure.
Yeah.
Wow.
The black outfit too. Yeah, everything just works.
He's a very cool looking figure to pose, that's for sure, the Mandalorian. But the little touches of Beskar and silver and color and paint. Yeah, it's a nice figure. Very, very nice figure indeed. All right, number 5. Let's see what we got for number 5. Oh my good God. This is a photograph?
Yeah. Well,
I know. Okay, so some may see this cheating get on there, but it's not really, because that is
all Black Series. God. Except for the 8 adapts.
A lot of Drew Struzan kind of inspiration going on in there, I think. But and a lot of reference to some of the old retro posters they had with those kind of little shines off them. But that's beautiful. To think every figure there is a toy. God damn. We Shoot Toys. That's some very, very good work. I hope I should have followed. Oh, I'm not following. I apologize. I am now. That's stunning.
This came in at 7,200 plus likes.
What a belter. The two little ARAT drivers down there. So absolutely, a lot of digital manipulation in that, but still, there's toys that make this up. That is...
Look, there's what? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 different toy photos in that shot, at least.
Goddamn. Worth it just alone for that, for all the hard work that they put into it, or she put into it, We Shoot Toys. Very nice. We are down to number 4 in the list. Let's see who number 4 is. And number four is, oh man, that's awesome. 1/6 year, I like it. I hadn't seen that before. Big Yoda and Baby Yoda. That's very, very cool. And we got some, oh wow, look at that. That's crazy.
Trevor's work is incredible. The detail yeah. that goes into the setups and...
Wow.
Yeah. Look how much of it you see compared to how much of it's been built.
I know. That's a lot of work for that shot, for all you see there. But it works. The leaves. Oh my goodness, that is amazing. That is amazing. I definitely follow him for sure. I'm going to be so embarrassed if I don't want to. Wow, that was... Okay, that was number four, so I can't imagine what the top three are going to be. Here we go. Number three in the top, Toy Photography 2019. Dun, dun, dun. I remember this one. This is nice. Stronix 117 again. Yeah, this was a very tasty little custom that a lot of people loved. He had this thing knocked out literally so quickly. Wow.
Look, I'll give the background of this to cover off again because people get upset and sometimes rightly so, and other times it's called the internet and what can you do about it.
Yep.
This is a Mandalorian warrior. It was created by a guy on Instagram who's a cosplayer called LoneWolf1183. It's his Mandalorian design. But, you know, the internet's the internet, and how you know unless you follow someone on who is the originator of something years ago is what it is. But Stronix117 has come across this design and made a custom of it, and it was huge. I think it went on eBay, and I'm not sure what price it went for and everything else, but I know that it was expensive on bids. Mm-hmm. And this was a post and a custom and a picture, etc., that, you know, garnered more than 8,000 likes.
Good God. That's a stunning pick. It really is. Wow. Nice work, Stronix. Oh, I'm embarrassed. I'm now following you. That was stunning. That really was stunning. Number two in the best toy photography for Star Wars Black Series 2019 is... I remember this. This is very well very well represented in here. That one was stunning. Yeah, that's right. Signing at a con, going to all that bother with the posters there. IG-11 in the background, Boba signing the poster, Cara Dune with a knife, that's right, and the little Jawa with the helmet on and the same poster. Lot of love and work went into that picture, and a lot of toys too.
Yeah, it's just perfectly executed. It looks like a Hot Toys photo.
It kind of does, yeah.
It does have that.
Go ahead.
Yeah, I was just going to say, it just has that look of, it looks bigger than the 6-inch scale.
Yes, definitely. The tone, the scale for sure.
Wow. The posing and the detail and everything, it feels like it's of a bigger scale than 6-inch, and it's a killer shot.
That is a stunner. Very cool. Mr. Nose Rain or Mrs. Nose Rain, good job.
Mr., it's Richie.
All the people that we've talked about today so far and those that we're going to talk about, everything, all the links to all this great toy photography will be under the video on YouTube in the show notes. We urge you to go and follow all these people. They are the best of the best, without a doubt. And again, don't forget to follow Matt's page too. There's links to his pages under there too. So the number one photograph by algorithms and likes and all sorts of other stuff, correct me if I'm wrong, is someone we have definitely shared a lot before, but here you go. Number one toy photography picture of 2019. 1/6 year. Ray.
Yeah, look, it's the Black Series Ray. It is the Hot Toy spirits behind, but at the end of the day, we shared it and it went off, I think, 9,297 likes to date. Far and away, the biggest when you're talking impressions, and you can talk a bit while I look this up, but I can tell you when you get to impressions and all that kind of stuff. I'll just look this up.
So while we were there, we'll just have a look at Trevor Williams' page. which I think we've highlighted before many, many times. But yeah, he's got some stunning work. And again, we just showed one of his pictures earlier on, but yeah, he has some epic, epic toy photography, from Lego to DC to It. So I think some Hot Toys smuggled in there too, and some stuff. What the hell is that? Okay. I dare you, I double dare you, I roach dare you. Okay. Awesome.
So we're talking about in reach and impressions. I think impressions is 99,000 impressions.
Good God.
And reach is 92,000 in reach. You can look up on the internet the difference between reach and impressions, but really it's just about how many people organically see the post beyond those who like it, kind of thing, whether it's through search pages, who gets served it, who sees it, who sees that someone's liked it, who's clicked on it for not following it, and kind of viewed it. So I don't know, Google it to find the difference between reach and impressions, but it really is kind of, I've never paid on my page to promote any image. So everything in my step is organic. And, you know, I guess it's natural that the most liked picture also happens to be almost the most reach or most impressions. I'll be upfront and say that the most reach and impressions was actually a, what would you call it? A mini video of a stormtrooper dancing in the kitchen and falling over. That was the biggest post of the year, but there's no point in sharing that. And then I'll say that not the most liked, but the most reached other shot was one of the promo glam shots of the heavy infantry trooper down on his knee with the gun. That was huge in its reach. That was 97,000 in reach. And I'm not sure what the impressions were, but it's kind of crazy.
Well, it's, I mean, it's an epic shot from the point of view that its composition is simple. Given that, you know, it's a background and a foreground, but really just having all those characters looking down, the shadow across the eyes and the lighting, maybe, of course.
Maybe go to Trevor's original post of it. I'm pretty sure that the only special effect used in the shot was the lightsaber. The rest is lighting and everything else is captured. I think it's in his comments.
Oh, wow. She's blown some smoke. Holy balls. Some smoke and some light, and snap the camera.
The only digital effect that was used was the lightsaber, to my knowledge.
That's awesome. That just adds a whole new dimension to it. It really is. To have an eye for that, to think about how that shot could come together. That's a really nice behind the scenes. That's pretty something else. Wow. Well, there you go. Top 15 Star Wars toy photography pictures of the year. But we're not done yet. We get some mentions, I think, of people in some other channels to talk about.
Look, in doing this, the only way I could do it, and because it was an impossible thing, I think I shared over 2,500 images this year across the 52 weeks. Just another stat thing, because I didn't share a top nine, but that generated 4.3 million likes. And in reviewing how to do this show, I kind of went through every month and kind of picked the best 10 to 15 shots, or my favorite 10 to 15 shots from the month each month, and that totaled 150 to 200 images. And I was like, we can't talk about 200 images.
No, we can't.
And there's a lot of repetition of artists in there, but so many multiple great shots. And like, you know, just off going through the 200 images from the 2,500 earlier today kind of thing, Shooting the Galaxy had a shot in there, but Matt's work was kind of featured every month. Every time he posted a shot, it was worth sharing. Jason worked more or less. Black Say, Swift Picks, obviously the C-3PO bros, I share all their work and love their stuff, and they makes up so much of the page, as does Chez Picks. Bud Futu with all his amazing dioramas, Tuscan Milk Bar. We had the little jowl shots in there. Dan Q Studios was coming up a lot. I share a lot of Mos Eisley portraits. There's a whole heap of guys Red Dog 5, a whole heap of people within the community who really make up the mainstay of the page. And I've already forgotten another 15 people now, but what we'll do by the time we do this show notes is we'll do some links to kind of not the best of the rest or anything else, but I guess the kind of community team, the guys who are, you know, putting in 30, 40, 50% of the images that I share are coming from a bunch of guys. And I'm still going to miss people on this list, but, you know.
Again, you love all your children equally.
Yeah. But not only that, it's that thing of anyone who's watching this show and has an interest in it, anyone who's following my page, I guess you can say, curates all their work, and it's a place to find it all. But every single image I share, you should click onto the original photo, the original artist, check out their work. And if you like it, follow that page, because look, that helps their engagement. That helps their algorithms. That helps, I guess, in for some people, spur their creativity and drive their page as well. It's not all about likes, but it's also about, I guess, if you're a photographer, not being in an empty room where, you know, you're doing this amazing work and it's not being seen or whatever. Like, if you're into toy photography, follow the accounts. And if I share 70% of their work, there's another 30% you're not seeing. And all these guys do really great work, and girls. Force of Light, there's Lizzie Force of Light, there's Threelise. I don't even know how to say it. Threelise, there's
tons.
Really great accounts. And my thing really for this page is, if you follow my page and you like the image, always be sure to check the original work. Because
that makes sense. And you do a good job of making sure the links are very clear to the page and the artist, which is, it's key. You want to make sure that these people are recognized. And like, I mean, I think at the end of the day, if you're an artist and you've made some of this toy photography, you want your work to be shared. There's no point in just sitting there quietly. The more it's shared on the internet with your link and your credit, then all the roads lead back to you. There's some good stuff. There was pretty some amazing behind the scenes stuff, which I think is always really interesting in some of the photographs we had there.
Yeah. And look, if you're a new account as well, you can learn a lot from checking out these guys and following their behind the scenes, looking at what they do. And we already talked about Stu and posing. And then there's people like Chris and Thomas Picks and Tuscan Milk Bar. If you want to look at sunsets and outdoor, they always do those Star Wars sunset shots and beach shots and all these amazing scenes. And the other thing the behind the scenes shots can show you really is what you can do in your backyard. You'll look at a shot that's there, and then you look at the behind the scenes shot. I think even if we go to my page now, there's something I shared today which has a hilarious behind the scenes shot and really shows you what a crop shot can look at. I know we're wasting a bit of time here, but we may as well.
You're all good. No one's in a hurry. What we got here?
So if we go down, I think down a little bit more. Okay, so that middle.
Yeah. Sorry, I had to stop there.
That middle shot there of the heavy infantry trooper and the stormtroopers. So is this Cyber Hubs? Yeah, Cyber Hubs. So there's the shot. Have a look at that now, and it all looks thing.
What?
Aside from the cat interfering, but if you actually look at the shot, it's a rock, a sand pit in a front yard or on a porch or something. We're not talking about being down at a beach. We're not talking about a wide shot. This is a tight shot on a porch.
That's nice. Yeah, you're right. It's as the toy photography is as limited as the person as person's creativity is. It's up to you what you can do with it. There's any number of effects you can have.
And where I can, I'll share the behind the scenes shots now that I found an app that lets me grab everything. Thank you very much. But it really is, it shows how people do it and can also teach you bits what comes out of editing and where people make things look cinematic and otherwise. But you can learn so much from starting out and looking at other people's work and
totally
getting inspiration from that and not getting disheartened. You don't have to live in Alaska with beautiful backgrounds behind you or whatever it is.
Exactly. And I mean, at the end of the day, it's this is all just having some fun. This is what you and I do it for. It's just fun to look at great toy photography. It's fun to sit and play around with toys and sand pits and make them. And then sometimes you get the fruits of the labor like this that we show on the show, and it's just stunning. Bring your cat along for some fun and giant paws of a monster. You never know what's going to turn out. But that's some good stuff. That's some good stuff. Well, we still got some more. We've got some really cool stuff. Now, Star Wars Black Series 6-inch is one thing, as you know, but we also look at, we love Hasbro Marvel Legends 6-inch figures. And 6-inch Legends is another page by His Nibs here, where he curates all the best of Marvel Legends. And we've got another top 10 for you here of some of the best figures of 2018. And straight away, number 10, I'm like, wow, it's such a cool-looking figure. So here we go. Number 10 for 2018 Best Picks is Keiko Collects. And it's the Punisher with the other Punisher head on it, which I did this too. So it's just such a good-looking figure. Love it. There you go. I mean, again, really not a lot. I mean, I'm not diminishing the work they did. They probably took hours to set up. But what I'm saying is there's no pyrotechnics. There's no sandpit. There's no cats in this one.
It's there's some lighting. And posing.
And lots of attention to detail and macro and posing. And absolutely lots of work in it. But you can do this. I think that's the encouraging thing to a lot of people is play, have fun, and yeah, look what you can get. Love it. That's such a cool pitch. Pick. Good job there, Keiko Collects. I thoroughly enjoyed that picture. Let's have a look at some more. So that was number 10. Number 9 is, hopefully you can see that on the screen there. Wow. Yes, I remember seeing this one. This was Toy Floxen. So a Marvel Legends figure, obviously with a little bit of paint.
Yeah.
A little bit of fluff and stuff.
What is it a custom head? It's a custom head, isn't it?
Is that a custom head?
Yeah, I think so. Because the
brown. Okay, wow. The blood on the blades just looks incredible. I guess Hasbro and Disney just probably really wouldn't do that, but that looks pretty awesome, actually. Kind of regret getting rid of my brown Wolverine now. Damn. Never mind. Number 8 in the list is by Fatal Black. Let's bring that up on screen. Again, that Punisher War Machine. What a killer figure. Looking really good there. Nice diorama, whatever that is. I don't think that's the NECA one. It looks...
No, it's not. I think it's a custom one.
It's awesome. I love it. And the pipe just looks really good.
As far as non-Star Wars, I don't think he does a lot of Star Wars, if any, but Pharaoh Black's account is incredible. Like, the breadth of stuff he shoots beyond Marvel Legends, and I think does a lot of NECA or Mezco, Mafex.
Yeah, we've seen some of his stuff on the page before. We've got some DC news about this figure as well, but we'll save that for the next show that we'll talk about. But yeah, he's got some cool, cool stuff. Very savit indeed. So that was number 8. Number 7 is, I love the name of this account, Deceptic Options. Da, da, da. Is it Deceptic Options? Have I got it right?
Options or Optics?
Optics. Optics. Did I say Options? Oh my God. Deceptic Optics is another cool pick here. Love it. Two solid figures, man.
And I don't have either of them.
What? Sacrilege, man. Sacrilege.
Oh, look, it was before I was doing Marvel Legends.
Yeah. You can't stop now, though, can you?
No.
Once you start, it's a slippy slope.
Look, you and I messaged each other today, and I saw the Fantastic Four wave and the Spider-Man wave locally at Zing. And my God, in hand, those figures are outstanding. Like, I mean, we already know that Thing was my number one figure last year kind of thing, but the head on this thing is incredible. It's slightly different, bigger eyebrows and whatever. Looks great. The other Fantastic Four look cool, but damn, Dr. Doom. He made my top 10 this year without having him in hand. I think he was number 2 or 3, but he is outstanding. I can't wait to get him. And those Spideys, I wasn't that jazzed about the Spidey wave. I got it anyway, but those Spideys look incredible. And the Vulture is great. Even the bunny girl, who I don't know who she is, and I don't care for the figure. But again, as a figure, she looks great. The paint on them look great. The Spidey armors look really solid. I'm suitably impressed for waves I was interested in, but not jaw-dropping. They really look incredible in hand.
Yeah, we get some good figures, definitely, to come brand new for 2020. So, and we get Toy Fair around the corner, so we get tons to cover. Next one on your list here is another War Machine. I mean, that's the third one we've had, but it's clearly a popular figure with a lot of others. People are really liking it. Punisher War Machine is a belter, that is for sure. Yeah, a lot of people are hard find. How is it a hard? Go online and order the damn thing. I don't understand why people are just trying to find things in stores. This is a fan channel exclusive, so no wonder it was a hard find. Exactly. Where is this being sold? Dorksey Toys, BBTS. Get on it, dude. Yeah.
That's from Toys and My Drugs.
Hmm.
That shot. Which is a great page.
Sorry, my apologies. I didn't mention that there. Sorry, I should have.
Toys and My Drugs, the photographer, but it's also a page a bit like Toy Tribe and stuff, sharing other people's great work. So,
yep, Toys and My Drugs. So they got a lot of cool stuff. Ooh, is a cool stuff. I saw that Thor today as well. That's a really good picture there. I like that. That's nice. Anyway, on we go. We've got a few more to go through. Finadin is next. And yet again, another Wolverine is in the top 10 of the 6-inch Marvel Legends toy photography for the year. Just a simple pose, but the lighting just makes that thing pop. God damn. Nothing custom about it. No paint. No. Just really, really nice. Nice and crisp, as a spot inspired by Andre says. I agree. What figure is it? That's a Wolverine. What are you doing on this page?
I guess maybe it's
just being facetious.
Isn't the inbox one was slightly different to the anniversary vintage one?
I can't remember.
A slight difference, or maybe it's just the alternate heads. I'm not sure. I can't remember.
Pretty much all good apart. The suit.
One was a darker brown and one was a lighter brown. Browns were slightly different.
It's still a sweet, sweet figure. Number four in the Marvel Legends top toy photography for 2019. Dun, dun, dun. And this is by Puntos de Articulation. I've probably murdered that, but Beta Ray Bill, bit of Nova, bit of Silver Surfer, and Thingy Bobber, I can't remember his name.
Mr. Something?
Sinister?
No, that wasn't Mr. Sinister, it was someone else.
Mr. Silly?
Do I have it in the hashtag?
Mr. Silly Cape? No.
Nope, because I didn't know what his name was.
Annihilate. See, did you let me to Mr. Silly Cape? He really has got a silly cape. But that's a nice picture. Nice team shot. And Nova. Beta Ray Bill, one of the ugliest dudes ever. Never mind. Number three of the Marvel Legends top 10 2019 is... That's awesome. Where's .my.sword? So we get Spidey and Juggy. Not the Juggernaut, bitch. And that's the newer one with the tweaks and changes to the helmet and so forth. What is going on there? That's nice. I like all the rocks. And that's this cosmic Spidey there. Not so tough now. That's nice. Where's my sword? That's a nice, very nice picture. Sure, follow him too. That's what everybody should do if you watch. And lots of cool toy photography on his page, including that very cool one of Beast with glasses. Number two in the Marvel Legends top 10 2019 is... Oh, okay. That's cool. J.C. Malone of... what cap is that? I don't recognize that one.
Is it the vintage one?
Alex Ross one.
No, is it the vintage one?
I can't remember. Maybe
the Toy Biz vintage card one. I think it might be that one.
Heroes in battle. Lots of explosions and stuff going on. Very good, GC. First Avengers. Nice. Nice. Tony Stark should not be drinking. He's an alcoholic, but never mind. I saw that again. I think I mentioned to you that Alex Ross thought today. You are right. It is pretty incredible up close. Well worth the purchase. So number one in the Marvel Legends Best Toy Photography 2019 is this. And we loved it at the time. I remember sharing it before with you, but this is superb. So simple and yet so good. And this was...
to the museum in New York.
Right.
And he has a relationship with them where they let him in go and shoot some stuff in there, and he kind of shares a tag. It would have to be the biggest diorama ever used for toy photography.
It's pretty good. Just sitting down on the wing. I like it. Good job shooting the galaxy. If you're not following him, Matthew Cohen, you should. Good job. Guys, get tons of cool stuff. Yeah, we shared this stuff many a time. Many, many cool photographs from Matthew. So that is the top 15 Star Wars and top 10 Marvel Legends. But more, there's more. What's the other 10 we've got, sir?
Look, if we want to do the Toy Tribe ones, yep. It comes with this kind of, I guess, note or whatever, a footnote is, this is the top 10 6-inch scale shots from the page, not the top pictures from the page where the 6-inch show. So I've left out any Hot Toys pictures or any Mattel or Mythic Legions or 7-inch, because ultimately it brings it back down to making it a contender out of any Black Series shots I've had, any Marvel Legends shots I'd had before I'd set up 6-inch Legends.
Yep.
Mafex, SH Figure Arts, etc. So, look, it's just, again, 6-inch, and it's just a chance to either share some accounts again or some other accounts that we haven't spoken about tonight. And, yeah, there we go.
So just for those that don't know, if you're just joining us at episode 51, go back. There's 50 other shows to watch. But if you weren't aware, so Matt Page curates, as he says, Star Wars, the Black Series. So for all these Star Wars photographs, that all comes together there. Toy Tribe is his page, correct me if I'm wrong, Matt, where it's just any toy.
It's a really? Free-for-all.
Yeah. Free-for-all, anything. All sorts of toys. Cool toy photography of all sorts. 6-inch Legends is Marvel Legends, as we just mentioned. So that was the top 10 we've done for both of them. But as we said, Toy Tribe is pretty much a free-for-all. But Matt's picked out the top 10. 6-inch figures, very kindly for us, and chosen by the algorithms. And I think this is one that I love to see all this ECBA stuff. The if that's how you pronounce it, I can't remember, the articulated comic book art, isn't that right? ECBA.
Yeah, that's it.
Nicely done here by Darth Zilla, but a really nice shot of the Scorpion and Spidey breaking at the wall. Coom, it says there. But I do love those effects; they look pretty good. Little cardboard pieces, and he's given us, oh, I see what he's done. That's cool. Nice. Recreation of comic book covers are always cool. He's even really tried to get the hands going there too.
Yeah, and you know, it's a very McFarlane inspired Mafex figure, and it's definitely, it was the, what would you call it? The McFarlane version of Scorpion with the green mouth.
That's nice. Darth Zilla. One to follow. Lots of cool stuff on his page. Number 9 in the list as we count down again for the best Toy Tribe photographs 2018. Wow. Okay. That is very nice.
There is some Photoshop obviously involved in this, but this is the Alex Ross shot. And if I'm not mistaken, I think BG Toy Art is the Hot Toys photographer. But this is the Marvel.
Yes, he is. Yeah, Hot Toys. Official Hot Toys photo blogger. One of. Yep. Nice. Oh my God, yes. Oh, let's not get in a rabbit hole. That's 12 inches. It's a whole other 6 inches on top of the ones we're interested in. That's very cool. So again, figure, but with a little bit of photoshopping. But yeah, that was a solid figure. The Alex Ross figures definitely were really strong. Yeah, cool. Number, where are we? Number 8 in the list for Toy Pride. Let's look at this one. Oh my God, X-Men Squad. Squad are all there. Very cool.
It's the Jim Lee family.
Bet that took ages to stage. Getting that right. Beast. Storm. Well, the gang's all there. I like it. They've really proved to be such a popular line, the X-Men figures. They've just been just stupendously popular. People are really struggling now to find the older ones, which is a bit of a shame. Moving on, number 7 in their list is Haro PS. I can't even
begin. I know. So here we go. So how it is it's the shot from Coroner 4. That's a casting cave custom Han Solo head.
Okay.
And it's painted by Harrop Star Wars The Black Series 6 custom. So gotcha. Jason Harrop, casting cave head. And yeah, it's great shot. And I remember it was very popular at the time. And that head is a great head. Jesus. That head sculpt is a great sculpt.
The head is great head.
It's a great sculpt. Yeah. It's SH Figure Arts. Han with the custom head. And again, as I've said many times and got in trouble, I love the look of the prototype shots of the SH Figure Arts Han head. The actual one didn't deliver. And this picture here for me encapsulates the best young Han Solo in 6-inch form. All the articulation of SH Figure Arts, and I love that. I love that Harrison Ford head,
yep.
And paint job and all that stuff. So,
and the Falcon, that's the nicest thing for me. It looks really nice. Love it. Moving on, Toy Snoop comes in at number 6 on the list. And that's a belter. Let me just bring this up. Sorry, I've just unshared. I'm enjoying the photograph, will you lot or not? There we go. That's awesome. Such a good builder figure. Again, I think you missed out on that one, didn't you?
Sure did.
You need this figure. This is one of your core collectibles, man.
They'll bring it back out again.
They will, actually. They will still bring it back out.
Every builder figure from the 3 years prior to the last 2 years is slowly making their way back out.
It's true. It's very true. And a good-looking Spider there, too, which...
It's the Mafex one.
I was going to say that. The joints look different.
Well, I'm pretty sure it's the Mafex. It's
the two heads that came with Rhino. Wow, they're just stunning. They're mad. One of them is just crazy. It's just insane. But yeah, that's really cool. Good job, Toy Snoop. Very good job indeed. Make sure I follow you. Again, if you're watching this, make sure you follow these guys too. Links in the description below. Number 5 on the list. Nearly the end there. Lovely photograph. I think we shared that at one point in the year. But a little bit of cotton wool, I guess. A bit of fuzz or something or stuffing. But it works. Looks really good. And I think he's landing on the NECA diorama display.
Ninja Turtles, yeah.
Yeah. But that's a really good job. Hyaron. I can't see it. Hi, Yaron. Why don't I just go to his page? There we go. And yeah, you want to follow him. Awesome shots. Lots of snowy stuff, Christmas seasons. I like it. He's cool. Another one to follow for the list. All right, we're getting down. Number 4. Nearly done, folks. What we got here for number 4? Wow. Isn't that based off a comic cover?
I think so, yeah.
I'm sure I've seen the Iron Man one as well. Wow! Okay. That is nice. That is very nice indeed. Yeah, we've seen that one before. God, there's some beauties, man. Such a cool figure. And Cap there. Nice snowy effect. So that is...
Is that yellow... the capital.
Green is yellow. There's the artiste here. We should get a little. Just go to there. Is that it?
Yellow is green.
Maybe
it's yellow is green.
Let's have a little look.
Nope. Oh, go back to the original post again. And click onto the page, the actual page, so that onto the cat picture.
Green is yellow.
Click on that again.
Oh, there we go. Nice. Ooh, lots of troopers and stuff too. Mandalorians. Oh, yes, you need to follow this person. So there we go. Like it. So we're down top three. Top three Toy Tribe photographs, or 6-inch photographs, I should say, of the year. Let's just look at that one. Venom. Now that's a different looking figure than I remember. Darth Liquid is the photographer there. Mafex, that's why. Yeah. I thought that was a Marvel Legends head for a minute, but maybe it is. Anyway. Wow. This looks pretty good looking. Oh, nice. Another comic recreation there. Of Spidey. That's cool. It's another McFarlane piece of art, I think.
Yeah. Like it. Definitely. Nice. There he is.
There's his classic signature. Venom. Very cool. And the number one picture. Did I get that right? Nope. Number two picture. I'm jumping ahead there. Number two picture for 6-inch Toy Tribe. That's awesome. Again, the squad is all there, pretty much. But they look good. They look very good indeed.
I just need to re-release Rogue. I need to do a Jean Grey scenario with Rogue and maybe, I don't know, one of her love packs or something. I don't know. Team.
I think they could almost re-release the entire lot and people would still buy them because there's still plenty of people after them.
Yeah.
You really could.
But aside from her, you've had a shot at everyone in the last 2 years.
That's true. And that shot there was by Toys for Life. Steve Saez. Very, very cool, sir. And some very cool shots on his page. So the number one Toy Tribe 6-inch photograph of the year, Kingpin. That is a very good shot. Crackhead 9000. What a lovely name. As he sits waiting for the phone to go. Again, it's all about the posing there. He's got the ring going, got the phone going.
And I believe the arms disconnected. Lowered down. So to get that pose, you've got the arms out of the sockets and resting in front of the head.
That's nice. Well, there you go. Good job, Crackhead 9000. It's you get some awesome photographs and more on your page. She-Hulk, Joker, Doom, Star Wars. There is so much toy photography, and that's the thing, and that's at the end of that. But I mean, you've cherry picked out the best ones there. I think of the year, Star Wars Black Series, Marvel Legends, and then just some other ones. And it just comes up. Some of them are really simple, some of them are really complex, but they're so good. You can literally, no wonder so many people follow all the curation stuff you have is. They look so good. They're so addictive. I literally want to go out just now and take toy photography. It is just very inspiring, and it kind of makes you want all the figures that you don't have once you see them. So very addictive. But very good. So that was 2019. That was a lot of photographs and a lot of likes and a lot of people engaging on stuff. But 2020, we got a lot of stuff still to come. So lots of Marvel Legends, still plenty of Star Wars Black Series. Mafex, DC are getting better all the time. Again, there's some new figures by DC, which we haven't shown you yet, but we'll cover them in the next show because January should be kind of quiet with Toy Fair being so close. I don't know. Anything you particularly, you really are looking forward to in 2020 that you're just, I want this, they have to make this. Everything.
Look, to be honest, I know we're going to talk about it in the next episode, but I'm really keen to see what you and I've seen today and others will have seen today, etc. The first look at the McFarlane figures. Mm. I'm really keen to see what and how much they announce at Toy Fair, kind of thing. Like, with the greatest of respect for Mattel and everything else, this is a new shot at DC again, and it's can DC become a Marvel Legends in their own game kind of thing, because Mattel had some great figures and they're really hitting their stride now as they lost the license. But I would say a few of the years leading up to the last year or so had been hit and miss. So I'm really keen to see how McFarlane goes with those. What else am I keen on? I'm keen to see what reveals we get from Black Series. Like, I know the 40th anniversary Empire will come. We don't have a new movie until 2022. We won't have a new TV series beyond Clone Wars. And that's if they choose to start making some realistic Black Series Clone Wars figures. That'll be interesting, which I don't think they will do. But it's going to be heavy on Mandalorian and heavy catalog stuff. So I'm kind of keen to see when that's announced. If we follow New York a couple of years ago for A New Hope, I think they just announced the 40th anniversary figures. Because they don't do a breakfast or a reveal, but they don't necessarily do a, maybe they do, I don't know. No, they don't have a stand, but they do a breakfast and then a presentation or whatever it was. So they, let's just say they reveal the 40th. What else will they reveal at New York, if anything? Or will they hold it again for in-year for more Mandalorian?
Yep.
The other figures we know that are rumored. Like, how much will they reveal next month on that, knowing that Empire has to be announced there? So,
well, I don't know. I think Jason Yakface, yet again, kind of let the cat out of the bag again about 40th anniversary, and a certain small, tiny comic shop e-tailer spoiled it as well by listing stuff. So, yeah, the cat's out of the bag. We kind of knew, and you know, I've hinted at it for long enough. There's more 40th anniversary on the way, and we'll maybe talk about it next time, and that'll give us some more stuff to chew over for Toy Fair as we begin to get excited for that. But definitely more Mandalorian is coming with it. It's got to happen, and I think it's showing how popular the show is. Everywhere you go, everybody's selling Baby Yoda stuff. And we're not done yet, so there's plenty more to come. But you just mentioned DC, and look, where we're here, why not? I've got the page open here. Let's just mention, this is the stuff Matt was just talking about. As he said, McFarlane, DC stuff here. Looks pretty solid. It does look pretty good.
22 points of articulation, which again is much more articulation than the McFarlane stuff's had in the last few years, probably similar to the articulation points as we'd been talking about last year to the Fortnite figures. So,
yeah, they come with stands. That's the exciting thing. Yeah, for me. Soup's looking good with a stand, Hasbro. You know, that would be great with the heavy Mandalorian to fly there. That would be great. You're not buying it just for that. Screw them. I want that for the stand. That's awesome. That's a pretty cool suit. Do you like that? Swap out hands and swap out bits. As you mentioned, that bats is kind of weird. Is that a collector card inside?
Yeah, I think they come with collector cards.
Oh, that's pretty nice, man. It is.
Look, I like the look of that Batman there, but when you see the other picture and in high res and close up, the head just looks a little bit more anime than it does look comic Batman. And, you know, look, the good thing about it anyway is there's going to be a dozen different versions of Batman.
Totally. There's an animated Batman looking pretty cool. Animated soups as he bends a piece of metal. Whoa. Superman. Okay, that's very Voltron-y. Somebody's put a picture of a kind of like Voltron or something. I like it. There he is. Okay. What else we got? Here he is there. Another Batman. Damn. Kind of killing that tiny stand. He looks absolutely massive. He can barely stand on it. But yeah, it's pretty nice. Wow. And there were some other ones, I don't know whether you've seen them, they've just arrived. So this is more Collectible the Batmobile. Wow. So a kind of weird Baff, if you want, the Batman Who Laughs. It's looking pretty good, actually, and that's pretty solid. Those collector cards, I love them. They're really nice. It'd be nice if that actually fitted in the stand as a nice little additional piece, but still, that will be popular.
Oh, Nightwing, cool.
Yeah, he's looking pretty good, actually. That is looking pretty good. That'll be a heavy one for a lot of customizers just to use the body to add all sorts of parts and pieces. Obviously, a very mini-scale Batmobile. This is what I think Hasbro needs to do, is these two little extra pieces would just make such a difference. He's looking pretty good. Excuse me, Batgirl came up as well, which is looking nice too. She looks very good. Lots of nice detail on that. Wow, quite impressed with this. And we've got a Harley, animated Harley, which is also looking pretty solid. We've had so many in the past from DC, but that's looking a little bit weird with a flat head, but there we go. There'll be many more Harleys to come. Then Green Lantern, Hal Jordan, I think that one is. Yep.
No, it's John Stewart.
John Stewart, is it? My apologies. Sorry, you're right. Hal Jordan, dope. That's pretty nice. Actually, I'm not a Green Lantern fan, but that's quite a nice animated touch.
I'm assuming that then, yeah, kind of almost Justice League United or whatever it was.
That's a weird Batmobile. That's the Batmobile?
Okay. No, it can't be. That's just some other kind of Batmobile, because the other one has the long front that was in the...
I thought so. Weird.
Look, you can see the Batmobile.
Yeah, you can. Yeah, it's why they've managed to give us this small, tiny, weird thing at the end and no description as to where that would be. Well, there we go. So, yeah, we get a lot of interesting, cool stuff. So there we go. We are up to date with bits and pieces that have came. But there's going to be a lot of surprises. As you said, as we've said, 40th anniversary of Empire Strikes Back. Empire Strikes Back, I'm so excited. I just love the cardback figures. So I'm super excited for that. More Mandalorian. Season 2 of The Mandalorian's around the corner, really, kind of. New Clone Wars, which could be new Clone Wars figures. It's going to be a good year.
Yeah, it'll be interesting. I'd like to see, here's one old request I'd like to see from the Black Series. I'd like them to do away with their rules about realistic interpretations of all things and actually embrace now, with less movies being made, and going, we're going to go 6-inch Clone Wars and actually make Clone Wars figures. The sharp squared heads, beards, okay, kind of animated. Why not? Why not go into that world? Because I've seen customs of them. They look outstanding. They did them in the 3.75-inch.
Yeah, they did, didn't they? Yeah.
Different lines and all that stuff. So it's kind of like, it's just another avenue over the next, 2 years. Who knows where this series, it comes to an end, but you can go back and go, okay, we can redo some of these figures. Some of them just could be re-releases of the clone troopers and their existing bodies, whatever it is, and just give them their new heads.
Definitely more clones. There's so many clones they've still got to do to catch up on. God.
Yeah.
More clones. Well, look, we've covered a lot of stuff tonight. Matt's page, instagram.com/StarWarsTheBlackSeries /6-inch legends /toytrade. You can find me at /FlyGuyToys. And we'll see for episode 52, I think. I don't think there's anything else, is there?
No, I don't think so. That's it.
Cool. See you for 52. Bye.
Bye.